Hi students, this is Vishwanath, Chemistry Faculty for NEET and IIT exams. In last class, we completed mechanism of Clemmensen's reduction. Now, see the next one, Wolff-Kishner reduction. What is Wolff-Kishner reduction? This reduction is also suitable for carbonyl compounds. Carbonyl compounds undergo Wolff-Kishner reduction to form alkanes. Here also, C double bond O group is converted to CH2 group. But reagent is different. See here, Wolff-Kishner reduction. Wolff-Kishner reduction. In this, carbonyl compounds undergo reduction with hydrogen in presence of strong base like KOH in ethylene glycol solvent. So compounds having carbonyl group, that means C double bond O group is present in the given compound, then that compound can be reduced by hydrogen in presence of KOH in ethylene glycol solvent. What is hydrogen formula? Hydrogen, its formula is NH2NH2, or simply we can say N2H4. This is hydrogen. It is used as a reducing agent in this reaction. Take an example, you can understand clearly. Example, CH3, CH2, C double bond O, CH2. This one, what is the name? Hexane 3-one. So this compound is treated with hydrogen, NH2 in presence of KOH in ethylene glycol solvent, or simply glycol. Both are same. Ethylene glycol, it is also called glycol at 180 degree Celsius. Then we can get alkane CH2. This one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. N-hexane. 6 carbon atoms present in the straight chain. So it is N-hexane. In this way, ketones undergo Wolff-Kishner reduction and form alkanes. Take an aldehyde, CH3, CH2, CHO. This is propionaldehyde. It undergoes Wolff-Kishner reduction. Then we can get the product CH3, CH2, CH3, propane. So in this way, aldehydes and ketones undergo Wolff-Kishner reduction and form alkanes. Remember this point, it is a base catalyzed reaction. It is a base catalyzed reaction. So simultaneously dehydrohalogenation takes place. Dehydrohalogenation Dehydrohalogenation takes place in the given compound along with carbonyl group. Halogen atom is present, then dehydrohalogenation also takes place. See the example for this point. If a compound contains halogen atom bromine triple bond CHO, this compound undergoes Wolff-Kishner reduction. Reagent is this one, NH2. Reacts with hydrogen in presence of KOH and glycol as the solvent. Then we can get this one. See this, from this hydrogen atom, both are removed in the form of HCl. In the given compound, halogen atom is present, then dehydrohalogenation takes place, gives double bond formation. Here, triple bond remains intact. There is no change in the triple bond. So we have to remember this Wolff-Kishner reduction. Wolff-Kishner reduction cannot reduce C double bond C, C triple bond C. Same, Clemmensen reduction also cannot reduce C double bond C, C triple bond C. Wolff-Kishner also having same type of property. Now, see the mechanism for this Wolff-Kishner. Now see the mechanism of Wolff-Kishner reduction. Take an aldehyde, an example, CH3, CH double bond O plus H2NNH2. From this, water molecule is removed. Then we can get this one, CH3, CH double bond NH, this one. This NH2 I am writing in this way, NHH. Now this compound is treated with KOH. KOH is a strong base, so it can provide OH-. In that case, these bonding electrons are shifted to nitrogen. OH- interact with this H+ and is removed in the form of water. Then we can get CH3CH double bond NH-. Now this negative charge is shifted here, positive charge, this pi electrons are shifted to this carbon. Then we can get CH3CH negative charge, this one. Now it is treated with water. In that case, H+ is added to this carbene ion, CH3, CH, hydrogen, N double bond, N, H. Now it is treated with KOH. KOH means it provides OH- ion. So this OH- interact with this H+. That means this bonding electrons are shifted to this nitrogen. Then we can get CH3, CH, hydrogen, negative charge. Okay. Now in the next step, this negative charge is shifted here. This bonding electron pair shifted to carbon atom. Then we can get CH3, CH, negative charge. Here N2 is removed. Here nitrogen gas, these two atoms removed in the form of nitrogen gas. So N2 is removed. Then we can get carbene ion. Finally, it is treated with water. We can get CH3, CH, H plus OH minus. Okay. So this is the mechanism for Wolff-Kirchner reduction. Aldehyde treated with hydrogen. From this, water molecule is removed. Then we can get this one, NH2. I am writing like this, NHH. It is treated with KOH. It provides OH minus ion. Then this bonding electron pair shifted to nitrogen. This H plus combines with this, removed in the form of H2O. Negative charge developed on the nitrogen in this way. Now negative charge shifted here. Pi electrons are shifted to carbon. Then we can get this one. Carbon ion is formed. Now this carbon ion is treated with water. From this, H plus is added to carbon ion. Then we can get this one. Now this species is treated with KOH. OH minus provided by KOH interacts with this hydrogen. Because bonding electron pair shifted to nitrogen, negative charge developed on this nitrogen like this. Hydrogen OH minus removed in the form of water. Now negative charge shifted here, bonding electrons are shifted to carbon. Then we can get carbon ion, and it is removed in the form of nitrogen gas. Finally treated with water. From this, H plus attacked at this position, we can get this one, OH minus is released. So this is Wolff-Kirchner reduction.